push, a little push back, about a foot or so, and we're good there.
Hey, listen, it's me, Michael B. Jordan. Getting ready to do this run, racing the plane. They thought I was crazy a couple years ago, and I was like, you know what, Creed 3, I'm racing a plane. Here we are. Action! It's great though, we got it. We got the acceleration.
From the moment that I met Mike, that it was a matter of time before he would direct. He had a great understanding of story and an ambition to him, you know, a point of view, a belief that certain stories should be out there and it should exist.
After we finished Creed 2, Michael B. and I had a conversation, and I asked him to direct the film. I thought Michael understood the character better than anyone else that could come in and do it. And it would be a real challenge for him, but he was, I thought, up for it, and he thought he was up for it.
I think Creed 3 makes so much sense for him. First of all, I think him directing makes sense. He's been working arguably his whole life because he started as a child actor. He's always been with these films. It takes a tremendous amount of preparation with the physicality especially, but getting to see him take that spirit of approaching the work in an almost athletic way was so inspiring.
I've watched him go from in front of the camera to behind it pretty much seamlessly because he's always a student. He's always learning. He's always trying to find new ways and take advantage of those resources.
Being able to reach out to like the community of directors that I'd never worked with in a professional capacity, but were you know, very open and willing to pass on knowledge and gems, you know, to me, you know, from Denzel to Ryan Coogler, you know, the list goes on. So to be able to lean on them and be available for any questions that I've had, it was priceless.
I was definitely encouraging him to go for it, and he had kind of picked this. You know, I think that he had been looking at this opportunity for a while.
It's nerve-wracking when you start with a new director. Sometimes you don't know what their capabilities are or what their vision is. And what was very interesting from the beginning is Mike had a very focused, solid vision of what this whole thing needed to be.
Michael wanted to tell something very personal that was going to be personal to everyone involved in the film. Him and Ryan Coogler go way back and I think have shared a lot of experiences. Michael had this really, really strong vision of trying to do something dynamic and unique, but he also was talking about trying to bring in these elements of noir and thriller and a bit of anime into it. That was really exciting to try and figure out how far you could push the boundaries of what a Creed movie was.
He helped create this universe, this world. And so he has a lot of good ideas, a lot of strong ideas as an actor and as a director.
He's risking it all. It's all on the line here. You know what I mean? That your name is everywhere. Your face is everywhere. It's on you, bro.
Cut. Great guys, guys. Great guys.
Gonna have to be more proactive than other filmmakers because he would have other work that he would have to do. You know, he'd have to be in shape and learn boxing choreography. And it was about setting up a system.
Filmmaking is a medium where you need a team. You know, so many other, you know, moving pieces and parts that come together in order to shoot a film. I think really leaning on one another and understanding that it's a full team sport was a big lesson for me.
We're gonna stay on you the whole time, so stay in it. We're gonna stay on you the whole time, all the way back to the corner. Yep.
The first couple of weeks that we shot, I think the crew was very surprised about his intensity and his commitment, and they supported him a great deal. Wherever he needed support, Michael got it from the crew, and he got it in a very, very loving way.
He understands that it's a team effort, you know? He understands that you know, to hold that belt up, it took a crew of people to get there. And I think Mike always crews himself with the best people, and he creates this a working environment where you want to strive to do your best. You know, this is a dude who willingly will take a punch, you know, just to get the right shot. So you give that guy your energy, he's going to do something great with it every time.
With Mike, it's just everyone's kind of chipping in to do what they need to do, the best they can do it, you know, without a lot of ego. Because Mike doesn't really present a lot of ego as an actor or a director.
Four cameras,
Michael was so awesome. He just made me feel comfortable and reassured me. He would tell me, it's okay, you can do it. And as time went on, I just got more comfortable and was able to do it.
Working with Mike, he memorized the signs very quickly with no problems, and he is aware of making sure that this film remains authentic. So he'll check in with me after he signs something and say, well, did that work? How did that look? Should I do something better? And I really appreciate that feedback and that open communication.
A memory that will stick with me forever, I would say it was one of the last scenes shot. And Michael B. Jordan had on this frog suit. And the eyes on the top of the suit just were so funny to see him in that. It was such a fun scene. I mean, we were playing around.
All right, we're ready.
Ain't no shame in my game, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying.
Is it you want?
I love working with Mike. It feels really safe and really lovely and actually really fun.
I've not felt more taken care of as far as the world building, what part I was playing. You know, it's never been so concrete in the best way, you know? And so there's a certain amount of faith you have in your director.
Every scene that we did, he was there with me. So I've loved not only acting alongside him, but also having him direct me. And I kept telling him, like, after our first day, I said, don't make me look crazy. You know, I'm trusting you, right? Can I trust you? And he said, absolutely.
Great job, bro. Nice job.
Really, the toughest scenes are Mike's scenes fighting. Because those are grueling. You get hit for real. They're long days. It's not easy to shoot.
He's an incredible director. And I think that we have a lot of great directors who started out as actors and kind of found their way behind the camera from in front. It was his time, and I think he had a good handle on what it takes to make one of these movies, and he just made the jump.
I've been,
you know, quietly watching and learning and listening, putting together things that inspire me, that excite me, and hopefully finding a vehicle for it, and that's what I did with Creed 3.